Oh, I just had to make another one. Let me say something. I'm reading it Sunday night. I'm going to post all these together. But I mentioned the Carlos de Luna case. And now what I want you to see is, it's not so much whether or not we do our attempt, and it was a murder case. But you can read the transcripts in the case, and you could see, out of all, this is the one case in the world where they say it's possible an innocent man was executed. It's out of Corpus Christi. And when you read the testimony, it's proven that the prosecutor and the cops purposely lied in this case. And I'm going to tell you why. Now, you can read it. And so I'm standing right here where this same office is lying in public in court. If you think it's a slight thing to go out and to, in this case, maybe murder him. And I'm going to do real quick for those who don't like to read it. And I just read him real briefly. Carlos de Luna was here back in, I guess, 83. You can read the case. He was accused of stabbing a clerk at one of our little stores here. I think it was a Shamrock store. These are names for little discount, quick stop stores here in Corpus. I remember the case. But Carlos de Luna had a friend, somebody he knew by the name of Carlos Hernandez. And de Luna and Hernandez looked alike, but Hernandez had a record, a history of stabbings. This girl was killed by a stabbing. De Luna had a record, but it had nothing to do with stabbings, but they both looked the same. And the evidence in this case showed that that night, Carlos de Luna said he ran into his old friend, Carlos Hernandez, they knew him from the streets, and that Hernandez was the one that was in the store, and he saw him in the store, and they ran that night. Now, they did find Carlos de Luna hiding under a vehicle, so it did look interesting, like, you know, he would be a suspect. But what's happened when you look at the case is this, if you want to read it. In court, Carlos de Luna said his friend Carlos Hernandez stabbed that woman. And the cops and prosecutors said that they tracked down a so-called name of a Carlos Hernandez and that there was no such person, that it was a phantom and a figment of Carlos de Luna's imagination. They lied in court because Carlos Hernandez had a record in Corpus Christi of that type of a crime, of stabbings, many arrests in this city. And it looked as if, I have friends in the streets, and it looked as if Carlos Hernandez worked. He was like an informant, which the cops here use. So they knew Carlos Hernandez had a history of this type of a killing, but this type of crime, stabbings. They knew he existed as a person, but they lied in court. They said he did not exist, and he was a phantom of Carlos de Luna's imagination. And the jury heard that. And when they investigated, everybody knew Carlos Hernandez. His family knew them. People here in town knew them. Cops knew who he was. So they lied. They think false testimony is something like, Mr. Skurka should go to prison. Just for the false testimony he's been given in court this week, that he didn't pressure, all these things, because the blood of the only case of a death penalty case that's questioned in the whole world, I read an article from The Guardian, it's a British paper, in the whole world, the only case where they question happens to be here, and you have cops and the prosecutor who said, there's no such Carlos Hernandez, and they knew him because he was an informant for them. He was a criminal. They lied. They gave false testimony. And the one case in the whole world that they use as a comes to the false testimony that was given by cops and prosecutors in the Carlos de Luna execution. Isn't that amazing? There's a spirit of deception. And the one case would be right here, right? Well, I'm looking towards where that is. Now, what you should have done if you thought you were just in your jobs, and I told you cases of cops, I could walk a few blocks and show you where they commit crimes. Right from here. Show you the places. Walk. But that's why you manipulating the system. That's why even in this local thing, you say, John, it's not a big thing that the district attorney, Skirka, is lying right now. We can see he's not. Night is a big thing. Especially when you had a man executed and you boldly as a prosecutor, and it was in Corpus Christi, where you denied that there existed a Carlos Hernandez. And you knew him because he was undercover with you. You lied. You gave false testimony. You're guilty of murder if that man was innocent. And I don't know if the woman was innocent, but you used false testimony. The truth would have been you should have said, yes, there is a Carlos Hernandez. And Carlos Hernandez later, after the execution of De Luna, admitted to everybody that he committed the crime, and the knife used at the scene was the same type of knife that Carlos Hernandez's family says, yes, he was known to had a certain reputation for knife stabbings. You think that's funny, you prosecutors? You think that's funny, you stand in court and lie? Your judgment day is here. This local cop, you know, if he winds up going to prison, getting arrested for sexual assault, you think that's funny. You laugh about that, don't you? You commit crimes by the words you speak. You've committed many.